I'm Devin Pellicone, lead engineer at Advanced Cooling Technologies. Today we're going to talk about loop thermosiphon technology and how you can utilize it for your system needs. A loop thermosiphon is a passive two-phase cooling device. It relies on gravity head to drive the liquid around the loop. You may be familiar with typical thermosiphons as shown here on the left. A typical thermosiphon has a pool of liquid on the bottom. You add heat to it, it evaporates the liquid, and the vapor just naturally rises to the top of the pipe. When you remove that heat from the top of the pipe, the vapor condenses into liquid and just falls back down by gravity. The liquid and vapor operate in the same space inside of the pipe. A loop thermosiphon operates on the same principles, but we separate the liquid and vapor flows in more of a loop fashion, as the name suggests. If you look on the right side image, we utilize the height of the liquid to drive the loop. This pressure head pushes liquid into the evaporator section. You boil the liquid in the evaporator and it creates voids inside of the flow. Those voids reduce the density of the fluid and that allows the liquid to displace the flow all the way around the loop. The two-phase mixture travels up to a condenser where you can remove some heat, condense the liquid back to its form, and then it falls into a liquid column to continue the loop. You can utilize this technology in a number of ways. It consists of an evaporator, a condenser, and just two liquid lines, one containing liquid, one containing vapor. As shown here, the configuration of the evaporator could be an aluminum plate where you mount your heat generating components like a typical liquid cold plate solution. You evaporate the fluid, it naturally rises to a tube fin type condenser. You blow air across the condenser where it condenses the vapor into liquid, falls back down, and continues the loop. The evaporator and condenser can take on really any form. It could be a flat plate, it could be a liquid-to-liquid heat exchanger, air-to-air heat exchanger, whatever is necessary. The only requirement is that the condenser is physically above the evaporator, so you have gravity to work in your advantage. Different configurations of the loop thermosiphon have been built here at ACT. You can remotely mount the condenser, as shown in the top right image. You can use flexible lines that gives the system designer a lot of flexibility in how you place the system. You can blow air from top to bottom or left to right. There's really an infinite number of ways that you can configure these systems to fit your needs. Finally, there's a little bit of performance data shown here. This is for a typical power electronics application where we're dissipating up to 10 kilowatts of heat. We're showing data for 7 kilowatts on the right. You can see that the two-phase nature of the cold plate allows your temperature gradients to be reduced. You can maintain all of your modules mounted on one cold plate within 5 to 7 degrees C, even at up to 10 kilowatts of heat. For more information, you can find it on our website at www.1-act.com.